Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. I worship Your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing Your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Worship Your holy name. You're rich in love and You're slow to anger. Your name is great and Your heart is kind. For all Your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. So bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like worship Your holy name. Bless You, time has come. Still my soul will sing Your praise unending. 10,000 years and then forevermore, forevermore. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. I worship Your holy name. Come bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Worship Your holy name, Lord, I worship Your holy name. Sing like never. Worship Your holy name, Jesus. worship your holy name. We worship your holy name.
Thank you. തൊള്ളായിരത്തി 1987 ഞാൻ ഈ സൗത്ത് ഫ്ലോറായിരുന്നത്. അന്ന് മുതൽ ഈ ഫാമിലിയുമായിട്ട് വളരെ സ്നേഹബന്ധത്തിൽ പരിപാടിയായിട്ടുണ്ട്. അവരെ സ്നേഹ സംസ്കാരങ്ങളൊക്കെ പങ്കുകൊള്ളുവാനും ഇടയായിട്ടുണ്ട്. സാധാരണ വീട്ടു സന്ദർശനത്തിനൊക്കെ പോകുമ്പോൾ നേരത്തെ വിളിക്കുകയാണെങ്കിൽ അവിടെ ഏത് സമയം ആകാനും സൗകര്യം മെച്ചപ്പെടുത്തണമെന്ന് ഞാൻ ചിലപ്പോൾ അവർ ഗേറ്റിൻ്റെ അടുത്ത് വന്നായിരിക്കും വിളിക്കുന്നത്. എന്നാൽ തന്നെയും വളരെ ഒരു അതിഥി പ്രിയായിരുന്നു പറയുന്നതിൽ ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് സന്തോഷം. സഹായത്തിൽ വരുമ്പോൾ തൻ്റെ സാക്ഷ്യത്തിൽ പലപ്പോഴും പറഞ്ഞിട്ടുണ്ട്, എനിക്ക് പല പ്രാവശ്യം ബൈബിൾ വായിക്കാൻ ടെലിവിഷനിൽ കൂടെ ക്രിസ്ത്യൻ ചാനലിലെ പ്രസംഗങ്ങൾ കേൾക്കുവാനും പല പ്രാവശ്യം സഭയ്ക്ക് വേണ്ടി മക്കൾക്ക് വേണ്ടി ദേശത്തിന് വേണ്ടി പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുവാനും സാധിക്കുന്നുണ്ട് എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു കേട്ട് ഞങ്ങൾ ദൈവത്തെ മഹത്വപ്പെടുത്തുവാക്കുകയാണ്. ഞങ്ങൾ വീട്ടിൽ ചെന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിച്ചിട്ട് മടങ്ങി വലിയിട്ട് ഇറങ്ങുമ്പോൾ ഒരു ചെറിയ വിളി കേൾക്കാം, വായിച്ച എനിക്കറിയാം വായിച്ച എന്ന് വിളിക്കുന്ന എന്തിനു വേണ്ടിയാണ്. ഭാഷയെ വെറുതെ വിടരുത്, എന്തെങ്കിലും സംഭാവന ഭാഷയെ ഏൽപ്പിക്കണമെന്നുള്ള നിർബന്ധം കർത്താവിന് ദാസിക്കുണ്ടായിരുന്നു. അവർക്ക് ദാനമായ കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങളെ ഇവിടെ ആയിരുന്നപ്പോഴെല്ലാം ദൈവിക ശിക്ഷണത്തിൽ വളർത്തുവാനും അവർക്ക് ഉന്നതമായ വിദ്യാഭ്യാസം കൊടുക്കുവാനൊക്കെ പ്രിയപ്പെട്ടവർ സഹായിച്ചതൊക്കെ ഞാൻ ദൈവത്തിന് സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യും. അനേക അനേക കാര്യങ്ങൾ ഇവിടെ നിന്ന് പറയുവാൻ വേണ്ടിയുണ്ട്, ഒരു സഭാശിശ്രൂഷ മാറ്റുന്ന നിലയ്ക്ക്. എന്നാലത് പറയുവാൻ വേണ്ടി ഞാൻ താല്പര്യപ്പെടുന്നില്ല. 12 മണിക്ക് മുൻപ് ഈ ശിശുഭൂഷ ഇവിടെ അവസാനിപ്പിച്ച് ഇവിടുത്തെ എല്ലാ ശിശുക്കളും അവസാനിപ്പിച്ച് നാം ഇവിടെ ഒഴിഞ്ഞുകൊടുക്കേണ്ടതായിട്ടുണ്ട്. തിരുവചനം ശിശുപിടിപ്പാൻ വേണ്ടി കർത്താവിദാസൻ ഉള്ളിൽ നിന്ന് പാഷ ജേക്കബ് മാത്യു അവർ കടന്നു വന്നിട്ടുണ്ട്, കുടുംബമായി കടന്നു വന്നിട്ടുണ്ട്. അതുപോലെ ഈ ശിശുവിടെ നടത്തുന്നത് ചിക്കാഗോയിൽ നിന്ന് കടന്നു വന്നിരിക്കുന്ന പാഷ ജോസഫ് കെ ജോസഫാണ്. ഡോക്ടർ സഭയിലെ പാഷന്മാർ പലരോടുണ്ട്. എല്ലാവരെയും ഓർത്ത് ഞാൻ ദൈവത്തെ സ്തുതിക്കുന്നു. ശിശുഷ അനുഗ്രഹമായി തരുവാൻ വലുവനായ ദൈവം ഇടയാക്കി തീർക്കുമാറാകട്ടെ. എൻ്റെ മനസ്സിലേക്ക് ഒരു ദൈവചനം വന്നതിലാണ് യോഹന്നാൻ എഴുതിയ സുവിശേഷം 14:1 വാക്യം മുതൽ യേശു തമ്പുരാൻ തിരുവായിൽ നിന്ന് സംസാരിച്ച വാക്യങ്ങളാണ്. ഗോസ്പൽ ഓഫ് ജോൺ ചാപ്റ്റർ 14.
Thank you. Shirley Ross era la vostra anima, anch'io la vostra. E lei, fratelli e figli, anch'io i vostri fratelli. Quando io si vede come a tutti i tempi, devo avere un white day service. But I never know I can come here for this service like this in a short span of time. But the death of Minola Mama is not the end of her life. It's a transition from one stage to other. Just like a caterpillar in the stage of a cocoon to a butterfly. If you ask me a butterfly, was the struggle worth it for the last 3 stages of her life? The butterfly would say, yes, it's worth it. How I can fly. Amama's immortal body, telling the celestial body, and we all know that she's promoted to glory. Her salvation, I will say. Even though Amama was struggling physically, Matukurjan took care of her. Family took care of her very well. I am very proud of my uncle, Patukuli Chai, because he made a covenant in September 18, 1973 that he will cherish and nourish his wife in sickness and health, in prosperity and other situations, all walks of life. And in the last breath of her life, my uncle did that and thanked her. I want to say one more thing. Can raise the bar so high for Malayali husbands, or especially husbands, how to take care of an ailing wife. I am proud. But there is nothing else that we can do after today for tomorrow. But one thing this motion is only telling us. Every human being has two destinations, eternal hell or eternal life. Amma chose the second one by accepting this as her personal story. His father is reminding you, if any of your family or friends do not know Jesus Christ as a personal savior, it's our responsibility to make sure they all enter into heaven with Jesus Christ. On behalf of our family, my brother is here to say that it's on behalf of our family, but my wife Mary and my two girls and our family members, I express our deepest condolences for the family and the peace of the Lord. Surpass all our understanding, may comfort Matthew Jang Shaggy and the other family members and the good Lord bless all of you.
Praise God. Let's pick the pastures. Matthew Jang Shaggy. Audrey, Shirley, Kai, and Kia. Joining with you again and discussing my deepest balances at this time. New Year's Day, I call Madhu Tenskans. Madhu had never been out for something that my mama has before, and we got a good conversation. At that time, she has to ask about my grandchildren, my wife, she asked about everybody. I never expect that is my last conversation. When I came for the IPC family conference, that was held here, I visited their house, and we got out about 2 hours to spend together with their family. When I got a call on Friday morning from my aunt, we were so shocked for such a sudden departure of our life. But it is God's time. We cannot add a minute or an hour or a second to our life if it's fast. God has a perfect time for every aspect of our life. We lost a valuable member of our family. She was with us for the past many, many years. Kolago example, in your challenge here. My, that's one of my second uncle. My older uncle is architect from Canada. He's on his way. My uncle Jan is the youngest son. And Maria Mama, from one of my, she's the youngest one of the family. So we are, my mom was the oldest, my uncle was the youngest son. So my sister Grace is here. She was staying in mom's house for many years and studied there. And they went to college at the same time. She was graduating from college. She was going to PDC. So we, part of our life, we spent a lot of time with the Mother of God. He was part of us. My mom called me and said, as far as the Lawrence, as she said, when he was young, she raised him. So she said that my grandmother was paralyzed for a short period of time at that time, and my mom raised my mother and said, please send my condolences. And she said, of course, that. We are five, my mom has five kids. I am the oldest one in the one boy, and my sister was the second one. Daisy was the oldest one in the family, and my sister Benjamin. And Ali was here up here, and the youngest one is Daisy. She is in Dallas, and her husband Sam is here. She couldn't make it today. As a family, when they are the part of the reason, I think we have to come up with moments. They are the part of the reason for me to be here, because they proposed my wedding. And I think in 1980, I was living in Bronx, Chad was in Brooklyn, New York. They were New Yorkers. So, first 6-7 months I spent at this time, I stayed with my father-in-law, Lacey George. And every other weekend, I went to Brooklyn. And I stayed in their house. I enjoyed the Brooklyn Mepinola Mom. She has a very good course for us. Every other weekend, we go there on the Sunday morning. Mother Jack, you take us to the church, we worship together at the time. So we had a good relationship with the Mother Jack, and in 1984, I believe they moved to Florida, and we lost their company in our life. We call Mother Jack Mani, or Mani Jack. He was always with me for us, as they mentioned that, always for us whenever. First thing. Always have that warm, friendly, loving, caring heart. Their family plays an instrumental part in our family. Since I was here, and many years when he was in India. Let me express my condolences on behalf of our family. Gracie, her family, my older sister. Macy, her family, my little sister. Sam and Daisy, my younger sister. I express our sincere condolences. All our children are expressing their sincere condolences at this time. There was a famous Indian poet called G. Shankarapuri. In one of his poems, he started with Indunyan Navani. But he was going in a casket, was passing for a poor man's burial, and he's saying that as the casket passed, there was a writing on that casket. Indunyan Navani, today is me. Tomorrow is here. How many of us did that? This life is not permanent in this world. One day we all have to go. It may be today, maybe tomorrow, maybe 10 years from now. But we have to be prepared for every moment of our life. I know that Punaloma was prepared for I heard yesterday, and she was spent a lot of time in Bible reading, praying, and she was prepared for that. How many of us do the same thing? There was a point also in 44 specifically. There was a point for Mary John Port or Sister Benita. She have a point saying that Togo Bebida, where the this world is saying that Olikali Jagatayim Jagatayim Pirinuna, Pirikanam Visamakum Rodu Bepanapada, Pirichu Pinda Mandi Nata Yatayana Dariya, Karakiruka, Karakiruka. So we live in, there is no good culture. We have to leave everything what we earn in this world here. But if you earn something for eternity, that will follow you. That will be the reward when you get there. In the book of Daniel, at the end he says that, go and rest. At the end time, you will come out to receive your lot. Our Pinola Mama went to rest. And she will come back to receive her reward in the last day. My friends, family, this is my reminder here. We have to go, like our Pinola Mama did. But be prepared. When the reward was divided at the end, what will be our reward at that point? That is what we need to focus. Work for the Lord, live for the Lord, and do everything you can for His kingdom. Family, not money, check, put your own money there, and they will receive the reward. Let me ask us a couple more condolences. As a family, my mom, dad, and all the siblings, and the children, and their spouses. And let's pass our deepest condolences for the family. Mathu Pichai, Shaggy, Yola Mama, Shirley was a member of New York IPC for while we were there. On behalf of IPC New York, Pastor Jacob George, and the members of the church, let me express my sincere condolences to the family. I am the National Secretary of the next 15th IPC Family Conference. On behalf of the IPC Family Conference, let me express my deepest condolences. Madhu Vichaya, Shaji, Audrey, Kiera, and Ryan Sherwin. This is just a good night. On that glorious day, Lord come out to greet the reward. Be there with her at that moment. May God bless you with that. Let God bless and comfort you. Let the God fill your heart with peace. Please pray for all the meeting members, especially for Matthew Chai, because his life partner left here, and he couldn't be alone for a while. But keep them in your earnest way. All the comfort that you peace in heaven, dwell on them, comfort them, and may God bless you, and God bless you in your service. Thank you very much.
I love thee in life, I love thee in death, and save unto death to your life, all of my problem. If ever I love thee, my Jesus, it is now. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Mama has the shadow of death passed over her, because our blessed Lord has died the death that we should have died. My name is Gigi, I'm the youngest cousin of Makujai. On the father's side, my dad is the youngest of the brothers. Matrukan's dad was the oldest of the brothers. Because my father was a pastor, we moved. So my early years, I grew up in really get to know my cousins and to do a lot of, spend a lot of time with my cousins in Rami. So my interactions with them has always been short when they visit us or when we visit them, even after I moved to the U.S. is the time that in their cousins or their children's wedding or when we visit Florida. So my interactions with the mama was short at each time, at weddings or with visit time here. I remember the last time, a few years ago, when we visited as a family, mama was not well to prepare the food, but she made sure she catered the food in. And when we were there, even though she was not very well, she was making sure that everybody ate and satisfied. She's keep asking, did you take this, did you take this, did you take this? She was concerned about whether we really enjoyed our time and satisfied. So we remember the love and affections, and that's what we remember always. Times like this, words cannot express our sorrow, but the God of all comfort, who comforts us in our sorrows, may He grant you His peace, His grace. On behalf of my family, who lives in Delaware, my wife Raymond and her children, my older sister, Sarah McJohn George, and her husband John George, who lives in Nashville, Tennessee, my older brother, Martha Cordillo, who is Joseph, and his wife Annie Joseph, and their son Ronnie and Joyce. Ronnie and Joyce lives in Boca. So their family and my mom, who also lives in Anaheim with them. My brother, Abraham Joseph, Rachel Joseph, and their children who lives in Delaware. And my sister, Rosa Mascaria, and her family who lives in Dallas. I want to express our sorrow and our sympathies and our prayers to the family. And also on behalf of the Alvarado Kanyapoli family, North American chapter, I want to express the sorrow, our sympathies and our prayers to your mother, Chayan, Shaji, Audrey, and the family, Shelley, our prayers are with you, and the God of all comfort comforts you in times. The Lord bless you.
Kudula Mama is my mom's younger sister. I very lovingly used to call her Kunyanchi. Kunyanchi was the first person from my mom's family to come to America. She left India when I was very young. And my memories of Kunyanchi, when in the olden days, when if you're the first person to leave your home, you have a lot of responsibilities, family responsibilities. And Kunyanchi worked hard. And I'm a living witness where she stayed in the car and met all those responsibilities. She blessed the family financially, and all the ways that she could, she worked hard. When I came to America in 1986, she made sure that my husband and myself would move to Florida and would start a life in Florida. She said, I don't want you to live in the other states and be a patient like me. I want you to have a better life. So that's how Martin and myself moved to Florida and we began our work here. In Kunyanchi's life, we didn't expect such a day would come so quick. But as we were preparing, especially this week, Shirley and myself were preparing for this, and I noticed Kunyanchi's Bible. It is the worn-out Bible. The pages are all worn. It reminded me of a saying, a worn-out Bible belongs to a person whose life is not a worn-out life. And that's typically, so Shadi and Shirley, we know Mom had a personal relationship with God, and that's the great hope. So the Word of God is the only one that can give us comfort and reassurance that we can go back to His Word and find ourselves there. Just like in John 16:33, in Psalm 46:1, He is the only one who can be with us at all times. Let us trust in His Word, hold fast, and run this race and be found faithful in it.
Praise the Lord. My name is Dan Lopez, and I am Matthew Chan's niece of the Basin. my brother loves to hear about you. And I came to this family in 1991 when we got married, and since then we've been living in New York and Dallas, and we had constant relationship calling, and we used to talk. The last time I met Pinyoma was here when we came for the IPC conference. We went to their house and spent a few hours there with them. And Mama was very cordial, and she was hospitable, and she took care of us. Even though she was in a wheelchair and she could not walk, the love I saw in her was amazing. And Mama also is from my mom's little town. Her father was a pastor, and my mom used to tell my mama's older sister was a classmate of my mom. Both of them are from Paramanta, not in Corrigan. And my mom also told many stories about their relationship. They went to the same church, worshiped before she went to Bombay for studies. And surely, we had a very good time when we got married, and we went to Kerala. And they were also visiting Kerala. I still remember those days. And as the psalmist says in Psalm 116, verses 15, precious is the sight of the Lord, is the sight of the Lord. Is that precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. So, Mama, we wish you good night, and we'll see you in the beautiful show when we meet our Lord in the morning. And Madhukar, with our prayers and our support will be with you, Shaggy and family, and Sherry and family. May God bless you. Thank you.
My name is Gordis Joseph. That's why I was kind of sat back. I thought probably somebody else. I don't know what to say this time. Mathukuti and myself, we go a long way. In 1968 on, we've been very close friends. In college, we were together. We were looked like a family back in Ryan. And this time, I don't know how to console Mathukuti. But ever since I came to meet this, I've been praying for the peace of God in everything, and that is the only thing I can share with him. And we lost one of the mothers for Shaijin and Shirley for very sovereignty, and condolence to the whole family. Just like we are all sitting here, we had a birth is a reality. We all born. It is a reality. Just like that, death is a reality. One day we all have to leave. I don't think 100 years from now anyone sitting here will be here. So let's have the confidence that when we leave this place, we'll be with God. That's our hope. God is going to come back. We can sure we have that hope that one day we will see their mother, and I didn't have a very close relationship with her, but I met her a few times, and I love the family, and God's peace be with you all, and thank you for this time you have given us on behalf of our family here of us at Lakeland. We were all close with Mathukuti and their families back in Kerala. And on behalf of all the families, we are very sorry with you, but we
thank you.
Wow.
അതിനുള്ള വന്നിടയിലേക്ക് ബ്രീത്തിങ് പോകും. இந்த சப்தம் வேண்டாம் தானே ஒரு அசுவம் இல்லைன்னா நீ எந்த கொஞ்சம் சாப்பிட்டு இத்தனை சீரியஸ் அந்தாரு உங்களுக்கு இன்னொரு வார்த்தாலும் வரப்பிள்ளை சிரிக்க தொடடி நீ கொச்சிலத்தான் காரியம் சேர்க்கும் வெள்ளும் போறேன் அல்லங்கில அவளை என்ன வெள்ளும் வழக்கு வரப்போ ஞாயிறு வெள்ளும் போறேன் அங்கே எனக்கு எங்களை எதுவே ஐ எம் வெரி சாரி தட் ஐ மிஸ் மை சிஸ்டர் பட் வாட் டே ஐ அம் வெரி ஹாப்பி தட் அவட பிரேயும் போய் அவட பிரேயும் கோபிள் போய் அவங்க ஒரு ஒரு துக்கமோ பிரயாசமோ கஷ்டமோ வேதனையும் இல்லாத சாரத்தை அவள் விசிரமிக்கவனும் ஞான விசுவசிக்கணும் குடும்பத்திலாய் குருமாதிரியும் சாதனை கொடுக்கும் ஞானம் வீட்டில் நல்லா பிரியப்படுகிறேன் கர்த்தாவ சமாதானம் சபையாக இருந்தவரே கர்த்தாவுடைய சமாதானத்தான் பிரார்த்திக்கணும் எத்தனை பேர் கர்த்தாவும் ஆலயமா காலையில் கர்த்தாவதான் கம்பீர நாள் தோன்றுவதாக சப்தத்தோடும் தெய்வத்தின் நாள் தோன்ற சந்தோஷங்களுக்கு பிரியும் கிறிஸ்துவின் மரிசனம் நோய்களுக்கு எந்த ஜீவனோடு சேஷிக்கிறான் அவரோடு ஒருமிச்ச கர்த்தாவை நிறைப்பார் மகாவாசி கிருஷ்ணா
Praise the Lord. My name is Abby Matthew from Dallas, Texas. I never expected my aunt, you know, want to be promoted to glory so soon. First of all, I would like to express my deepest condolences on behalf of myself, my wife Lena, our kids, the mother Chacha, Sholimon, Shajimon, Audrey, Ryan, and Kyra, to all the family and friends. One thing I remember about Kodoma is she used to say, Monet, I pray three times for you. I'm going to miss my Kodoma's prayers on our behalf. Kodoma was a woman of faith. She believed that the Lord can change any situation. I remember when we came to New York in 1982, when we used to go to school in the morning, but no one used to work at night. And after the night shift, when we were going to school, she would come, and it was so hard for her to, in the snow, climb up the steps to her house. But she did it. And 2 years later, in 1984, we moved to Florida. And then in 1987, we visited them in Florida. And I was so surprised to see Kodoma very healthy, driving her car. And I could not believe that Kodoma was driving her car. She took me to Publix supermarket, and we did shopping together. And she told me, Monet, be very careful. The roads are very dangerous here. And I was looking at all the memories that we had together. The last time I saw my grandma was in May of last year when my dad passed away. At that time I asked her, Mama, how are you doing? She said, Monet, I'm pulling on. You know, that was her statement, pulling on. 2 weeks ago, I saw a vision. In that vision, I saw there was a big prayer meeting going on. And it was one of the dear aunties. And after the meeting, I went to the auntie and I asked the auntie, "Auntie, how are you doing?" And she said, "Morning, I will go, but I will come back and then I will go again." So, you know, it was a little bit strange to me. And then a week after that, I saw a white plane landing. So, you know, I thought it was one of my Shivajajan's mommy. She was in the hospital at that time. So I called Shivajajan and I said, "Shivajajan, I saw this dream. So be careful with mommy, because, you know, it might be the calm before the storm. So just be prepared." I never knew it was going to be for Gunawa. You know, she said, "In the morning, I will go, then I will come back, and then go again." She had the attack, and then she went to the hospital. She was revived for some time, and then she went again. Went home to be with the Lord, and then I saw a white plane, you know, taking her to glory. So I have that peace in my heart, definitely, that she was a woman of prayer. She was a woman who knew the Lord, and she is in heaven. And we are going to see her when the Lord comes, or when we, you know, be with the Lord. So, you know, at this time, again, express our deepest condolences. I know that, you know, God is with all of us, and God will comfort you.
As a child, I remember visiting her at Sai Hospital, Mumbai, where she was studying for her nursing. And later on, she went to work at the same hospital. Here lies a woman who was brave enough to cross an ocean and immigrate to a new country alone, with no other family members at New York to comfort her. She played a vital role in improving the financial stability of her family back home in India. I think her greatest passion was her family. She had a strong sense of duty as a mother and a wife. Over the past few years, I saw she became weak, but that did not deter her from reading the Bible and praising God. I had the privilege to talk to her over the phone minutes before she had the first cardiac stroke. We will remember her. Her memory will be with us and of all of us in the days to come.
I'm going to sing a song for my mom that she liked it. And maybe you know it in this week by the way.
To prepare us a dwelling place. And I remember my mom, when I was in middle school and high school, at night she would come, you know, at night come over, put her hand on my brother and my head and pray for us. I remember every time when I was going through a trial, something happened, and it seemed like, oh my gosh, you know, I would call my mom and count on her prayers. Like, she would fervently pray and pray and pray. And I believe, you know, the prayers of my mom really carried me, my brother, and our family through a lot of things. My mom was super organized. We sometimes laugh and say she was like the CEO of the house because my mom did all the bills. You know, she had all her calendars, and to this day, even come in the house and seeing my mom's handwriting on 100 different things because my mom was that neat and organized, you know. Now that I come to this side of it, and I'm like, God, you know, do I trust you? God said, you have to trust me. And in that moment, when I found out what was going on, it was like, trust me. And I come here, and I've lost my mom. She's not here on earth anymore. But I believe that she's with heaven. She's in God in heaven. She's not suffering anymore. And even though I won't talk to her, because I talk to her every day, and I talk to her in the afternoon, even though she won't be there to call me, she wouldn't go to sleep unless she knew I was home at night. Every night, like, you know, are you home? Did you get home yet? And that's when she'd have the peace to go to sleep. And so that's just like a glimpse of what kind of mom she was. She taught us and taught me about sacrificial love. Like, she would do anything for her children beyond measure. And I bless her for that. So I say this to mommy that, you know, I will make you proud and I will live to honor you and what God's destiny is for my life. And that, you know, my life will be made, your life will be made. And you know, many times my mom would call, look, sugar, are you praying? Are you reading your Bible? You know, and she would be like, you know, Mom, please pray, read your Bible. And that was her constant thing for me. She would please, you know, read your Bible, pray, read your Bible. Are you praying? Are you reading your Bible? Are you spending time with God? And, you know, that was her desire, you know, to see me walk in a relationship with God. And so I just wanted to say that, you know, I'm going to do all that I can to live my life to edify God. And although I don't understand why Mom was taken so soon, I'm going to trust God. Because from that moment I heard that first thing, I heard that. He just said, trust me. But I thought it was a different outcome. But God is still good. He's still a good and faithful God. He's worthy to be praised. He knows everything. He's sovereign. He's in control. And I praise God for that. But in that moment, I was wondering, God, where were you with her when she took that last breath? And I got confirmation. And I thank God for that. Several people in that moment, I was thinking, were texting, like, you know, God was with her in that moment. And so it was just in that time frame when I was thinking, God, like, I wasn't with my mom when she took her last breath, you know. And but I know God was with her. And so for that, it can't get any better than that. So I thank God for that. And my life will be for God and His glory, and to honor my mom whatever I can. There are things that God has put in my heart. And, you know, I ask for your guys' prayer that I will be able to honor her life. And I'm thankful for everything she ever did for me. I bless her. And, you know, just we'll come to your guys' prayers. And again, thank you all for your love, support, you know, your prayers, your thoughts, your actions. everyone who volunteered, everyone who did worship, and you know, worship was so critical to me, and I thank you all for that, and just being able to come together last minute, and I bless all of you. And I say this to you guys, you know, you never know when the last minute is with your loved one. So I say this, like, when people say, live your day with your family loved ones as it's your last, do that. For all of you guys, you know, with your family, if you guys get, if there's, you know, issues, like, you know, people get angry, people get upset, you all get hurt, I say to you guys, is it worth it? I wish I had more moments with my mom. So I say to you guys, you know, it's not worth it. So if there's any kind of unforgiveness or bitterness, you know, I ask for all of you to deal with that in your heart. And just know that, you know, tomorrow is not promised. And, you know, keep your loved ones close and remember that, you know, we're just fleeting. Life is fleeting, you know? We're dust. We return back to the earth. And so just remember that and cherish your loved ones and, you know, always believe that this might be your last day with them. It's not worth it. You know, ask God to give you the eyes, give you His eyes to see that how He sees them. You know, even when they've hurt you or they've, you know, done something that you think is so unforgivable, I ask that you deal with that in your hearts with your family, you know, to give you the strength to see them, you know, and deal with unforgiveness. Just know that, you know, I praise God in this moment, even though it hurts, and the days to come is so unimaginable. In this moment, God is worthy to be praised because I know He's faithful, He's sovereign, and He loved my mom, and He's taking care of her. My mom is not suffering anymore. So, thank you guys again for everything, and you know, I love you all of you. I bless you guys from the bottom of my heart. Thank you for everything.
Praise the Lord. My name is Saji, and I am Matuka Nikunimo's son. I'm here with my wife, my son Ryan, and daughter Kira. People, you often give names or labels to people. For some, she was known as Cooper City Kunimo, or maybe Florida Kunimo. Others who knew me well, my friends over the years, were as Saji Han. To me, she was simply Mommy. Over the past week, people have described Mommy to me in conversations as unique, special, particular. Someone very dear to me said that they have met many people in their lifetime. And no matter who they ever meet in the future, there'll never be someone like her. Mommy was an amazing woman. She had many redeeming qualities, and one of them was her belief in the power of prayer. She prayed continuously, daily, nonstop. One example of the power of prayer in our life happened when I was very young. In about 1979 or 1980 in New York, it was a Saturday night, and we had gone to a prayer service at a fellow church member's house. And while we were at the prayer service, it started snowing. And after the prayer service and dinner at the house, we left. And while on the highway, Daddy's car broke down. And we're on the shoulder of the highway. And back then, there were no cell phones. There's no way, there's no GPS, there's no OnStar. And the car was broken down on the highway. And it was snowing, it was cold. And we don't know where the nearest exit is. And back in the day, there was no car seats. I'm in the front of the car. Mommy, 4 or 5 years old, front seat with Daddy. Mommy and Shirley, who was about 2 or 3 years old, in the back seat. And people would stop, try to offer their help, and Daddy would give them some money. They would look at the car and say, "I'm sorry, I can't fix the car." Mummy's nonstop praying. I'm falling in and out of sleep in the front seat, cold, surely sleeping. Daddy's dealing with the people who are stopping by, and despite their promises that they'll call a tow truck, hours will pass by and no tow truck has come. Around 1:30 in the morning, a car stopped, and a Hispanic gentleman came out. He said, I was at an overnight fasting and prayer, and a vision came to me that said, my children are out there. Go help them. And he got his car, he left the prayer service, got his car, found us, and said, I'll help you. He tried to fix the car, he couldn't, he went, called the tow truck, came back, waited with us for the tow truck. Tow truck came, he waited with us and the car got in the tow truck. He followed us all the way home to Brooklyn. And when the tow truck finally stopped in front of the house, he left. We never saw him again. I am confident that Mummy's prayer helped us that night. I am also confident that any success we have, personally or professionally, is because of Mommy's prayer and God's grace. One of other Mommy's qualities was that she worried a lot. It was out of love, no doubt, but she worried tremendously. I went to college locally here at Nova Southeast University, which is only not even 15 minutes from the house. And in my second half of my sophomore year, I moved on to campus where I stayed until I graduated. And I would come home at night after classes and meetings, because I was involved in various things at college. And I would see in my voicemail, you have 6 messages. Wow, 6 messages. 5 of them were for Mummy. Morning, are you okay? Are you eating? Are you studying? How is school? Despite the fact I'm 15 minutes away, she called that many times to worry about me. As you know, we, Audrey and I and the kids, we live in New Jersey. And New Jersey is a big state, and sometimes she would watch the news and see there was a snowstorm in Cherry Hill, which is about 2.5 hours away. Or she would see an accident in South Jersey. She would call, Money, are you okay? My money, it's fine. It's 2.5, 3 hours away from me. Despite telling her, she would constantly worry about that. Sometimes we would go on vacation, not necessarily tell Mummy what we were doing, because we knew she would worry. We would tell her after the fact, Mummy, yes, we went to the beach today. The kids swam. She was at, even though the water only came up to their ankles, she was concerned. But that was Mummy. Since yesterday and today, we've come to look at her in the coffin. But that's not her. That's a shell, a facsimile. I will not remember her like that. I will not even remember how she was, her like she was the last several years. Rather, I will remember her kneeling next to me as we said our prayers as a child before we went to bed. I will remember her trying to feed me as a child. I was a picky eater. And she just wanted to make sure I ate. So she allowed me several times to clear out one of the lower cupboards, clear it out so I could climb in there, pretend to be a cow, so she could feed me. I will remember her and Daddy in the kitchen making chapati and chicken curry, maybe my favorite meal, Indian meal as a child. I will remember her as the person who, during a fire on the medical floor, helped escort people out, making sure no one was left behind and suffering severe smoke inhalation. I will remember her as she would run out of the house after me whenever I went somewhere with my friends, asking them, where are you going and what time will you be back? And she would tell them, be home, bring Sasha back in 1 hour, even though it was only 5 p.m. I remember her as she sat or laid awake on the couch waiting us for come home, even even if we were grown up adults with kids, she would still wait up for us. In moments like this, we try to find words, and I found a poem that captured one essence of Mummy. Please bear with me. She always leaned to watch for us, anxious if we were late. In winter, by the window, in summer, by the gate. And though we mocked her tenderly, who had such foolish care? The long way home would seem more safe, because she waited there. Her thoughts were all so full of us, she could never forget. And so I think that where she is, she must be watching yet. Waiting to come home to her, anxious if we are late. Watching from heaven's window, leaning on heaven's gate. Some of you know, we flew in from New Jersey on January 6th, and we were in the airport, we left the airport only a few minutes before the shooting occurred. We have no doubt that Mummy was looking down from heaven and asking God to protect us that day. Some of you may have realized from the program that yesterday, January 12th, was Mummy's birthday. Most of you don't know that January 12th is also Daddy's birthday. And yesterday was the first time in 43 years that they were not together to share their birthday. They were not together to share their birthday. But they are and will always share their birthday in spirit and in love. I just want to read two verses before I close. In Revelation 21, verse 4, it reads, "He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and death shall be no more. Neither shall there be mourning, nor crying, nor pain anymore, for the former things have passed away." In Matthew chapter 11, verse 28, Jesus said, "Come to me, all of you who are weary and carry a heavy burden, and I will give you rest." I miss Mummy, but I'm happy that she's free from her pain and suffering she has suffered for so long. Mummy, it's time to rest. You have fought the good fight. You have run the good race. You have kept faith. Thank you for everything, Mummy. I love you.
She's dedicated to him, Roy, and the person who was a present, only we know from the beginning, you know, Dr. Philippa and Gina, this year, you know, they are starting their journey together in Brooklyn. So in Brooklyn, we stayed and we attended the Church and the Gospel Church. We took our last year and raised our children in the past years of the church. Then we had two children, Shahi and Shahi, born in New York, Brooklyn. Then day before, we moved to South Florida. So, to all this time, we know it was very dedicated for the work as well as the family and the church. And friends, she's a very unique habit, a very unique habit. Very punctual, very clean, very organized. Anyway, we start our life in Florida. After that time, we don't know how to try to she don't want to give it to the babysitter. So she thought of that. So we start. I started the job by the paper up to the retirement age. Yes, I can't work there. So because of her physical problem, she retired from the as a supervisor and thought about the state of. As I mentioned, she's very dedicated. She didn't care about her life. She, one time, she's a supervisor in the floor. They said, somebody spoke in the bed, there was a fire. She didn't care about her life. She stayed at the station up to the last one. That one was so affected her life. So she got a many recognition from the job. It, one day she's very lucky when my son Charlie got a mini award, he's a principal award, he's a called another kid, a silver knight award. So all this special summary is she can not operate or catch it. I follow. No, I am not wasting my time. By the grace of God, in my job place, every year, 3 to 4, recognition, ceremony, function on that. So I got an opportunity to take care of Vinamala, my wife also. So everybody knows Vinamala all of that. Chief Pharmaceutical, Sherry, finally. Merck, so she cannot do any functions, she was in the United States, so every time when you go, they recognize her also, because this, during this my, for 29, 30 years, I never called sick. Every day, I quit work. So he get the best attendance. So during that time, they praised my wife. Because it is there. And every morning I start my job 6 o'clock, so I wake up 4:30. She wake up with me and prepare breakfast, lunch. So sometimes only one Indian family I work in that facility for a long time. Then when we cook the food, we have warm the milk in my drawer. They know it's Matthew's food. So, she takes care of, she prays a prayer for you. Every time, not a premium, early morning prayer and not evening prayer. She wants to sing 3 songs. Sometimes I, you know, I am only praying. She prays, read the Bible. She wants to know, she will feel quiet there. You don't want to get famous, you don't know everybody what she's doing, what she's doing, she tells me out of conversation. So, she has many things, but I'm at least talking about it. Now, she is a place, no pain, no suffering. No, but the first day, even if she takes the treatment, I am helping her. So, first, if you go and clean the face and everything, I go after that. Then, on the way, I had in my old manga. I went there. She's in the taking task. So, I called an emergency, they came and took the hospital. They tried their best, but they didn't save it. God called her up. No, she's not in the pain, no suffering, no any, don't have to worry about any bill or payment or anything. So he helped me in our family many times to organize all these business bills and account and everything. Sometimes I am working even though she's retired from me, no one will work. She take care of me very much. No, she's ready. No pain, no suffering, no one. But one day we can see her in the world. concerned, many people call me. They ask me, is anybody with you? I'm like, God is with me. So I only need your support, prayer, and this time I am extending all my sincere thanks to all our friends, relatives, cousins, church, and my neighbors. So most of this, our family in the country and community, 200 houses. Or most of them, they know me because we have some fruit trees and coffee. Everybody come and get it. So that way, we know anymore I'm me. I'm thanking for my neighborhood. Please pray for us. Thank you. Some of my cousins came from far because of this. There's no snow, the cold weather. Even though all these circumstances, they came and joined this occasion. Still one more minute to do. God, it's not going to be here, because of the snow in the Toronto, he's stuck there. I hope he will be here and maybe later. Thank you for everybody. God bless you. We see you. All this critical situation, live with one another in the name of God and comfort us. Thank you. God bless you.
This is not the picture that you would see in other situations. There are people who don't like Friday the 13th. There are people who don't like to take pictures of loved ones who are departed. They said it brings fear, terror. They don't feel comfortable looking at those pictures. In the book of Job, one of Job's friends, Bildad, he characterized death as king of terrors. This is what he says. He is torn from the security of his tent and marched off to the king of terrors. This is a picture that you would see out there. But in the book of Hebrews, we have a very powerful word. It says that by embracing death, taking it into himself, he destroyed devil's hold on death and freed all who covered through life, scared to death of death. That's the Message translation of it. It's through the death of Jesus. God delivered us, the humankind, who were slain to the fear of death. Thank God that we are able to stand here and speak about words of hope without any fear. All of it because of the death of Jesus on the cross for us. The fear of death is removed because Jesus died in our place. Paul and people like him said, I desire to die and be with the Lord. Here's a group of people who are afraid of death. But on the other side, we see a group of people who said, I'd rather be with the Lord. Whether it's death or life, that's not matter for a child of God. And this morning we are here, calm and quiet and composed. It's because of the joy of salvation that we experience. In the Bible, speaks about death as an appointment which nobody will miss. In Hebrews chapter 9, verse 27, just as man is destined to die once, and after that to face judgment. This is one appointment that nobody will miss. Today or tomorrow, I came across a fable said about a Baghdad merchant. He sent his servant to the city to buy some stuff. When the servant went to the city, he came face to face with death. And the death gave him a menacing look. So he got so scared and came back and said to his master, "Give me a horse." He said, "Why do you need a horse?" "Death was looking at me today. I'm terrified. And I want to escape and go to a place called Samarra." So he got the horse. He left for the next city. So the master decided to go to the city and see death face to face and ask him, "Why did you give such a look to my servant?" He went there. He saw the death in the city. Asked him, "Why did you look at my servant that way?" He said, "Today I have an appointment with him in Samarra, and I was surprised to see him here in the city." It's a story, but it really tells us that death is a reality. It will come. It's an appointment nobody will miss. I always tell, preach in my church, it doesn't matter when you go shopping. You can pick up anything and look at the calorie count. There are some people who take the water bottle and look at the calorie count. All the exercise, 2 hours, pray 2 minutes. Do everything possible to be alive. I'm not against any of those things. But something good for us to remember this morning, death is an appointment. It will come at the appointed time. The question is, are we prepared? Sadhu Pajjanuvadeshi, a revivalist who touched the heart of Kerala, has so many songs, and one of the songs very interesting. He said, "Padanayiram nila pokki padanayiram, adinullilum mrityu kayarichu." Even if you build a 10,000-story building, death will come inside of it very easily. It will come. In a certain way. But it also calls death. In 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, Paul really speaks about, "We believe that Jesus died and rose again, and so we believe that God will bring with Jesus those who have fallen asleep." It is actually describing the state of the body, not the state of the soul. Bible speaks about 3 different kinds of death. One is physical death, which is your soul separates from your physical body. Second one is called spiritual death, which is your spirit become unresponsive to God. That's the reason the New Read Bible, Jesus tells, "Let the dead bury the dead." That means let spiritually dead people bury the physically dead people. But it also tells us there's a third kind of a death. That is called the eternal death. That is a spiritually dead person, without turning to the Lord, dies physically. And he enters into a stage where he is totally separated from God forever. But here in this context here, Bible is speaking about a sleep. And you know that when a person is sleeping, only things to all of us who are alive, be operating physically, they are not, you're not able to relate to them. But a sleeping person is alive, in another sense of the word. A sleeper does not cease to exist while their body sleeps. That person continues to exist despite his absence from the region in which those who remain sleep. Bible also realistically speaks about decomposition of our body. Bible tells him that you are taken from the earth to the earth. You shall return. Bible calls about death as a journey, death as a departure. I said death occurs when the spirit leaves the body. As a body without the spirit is dead, so faith without thee is dead. And again, it's talking about body without the spirit. In Acts chapter 9, when they were talking about Tabitha or Dorcas, this is what they say. The Christians, the widow stood nearby her body and showed the garments she had made while she was with them. Her body is still there, but a departure has taken place. In Philippians chapter 1, verse 23, we read, I desire to depart and be with Christ, which is better by far. In Luke chapter 9, verse 31, you read on the Mount of Transfiguration. It says that they talked about his exodus, the one Jesus was about to complete in Jerusalem. So this is called an exodus, a departure, a journey. And we know that the word departure has so many meanings to it. In a nautical sense, it's a ship that was in the harbor for a very long time, finally set sail, and it is moving, going off the shore. It's like a camp is now folding, moving to a brand new place. An oxen's burden is lifted up and is set free to a child of God. That's what death is all about. It is face to face with Christ. I still remember many years ago, myself and my wife, we were visiting a home where Aramachi just passed away. And the pastor and wife, they were married for 60 years or so. So when we went there, her body was taken to the mortuary. So the father of the pastor is praying. That's what he prayed. God, I thank you for giving her to me. And we lived together for the last 60 years. And she was good to me, all those things. And finally, this is what he ended up the prayers. He said, but Lord, I know when I come there, I will see her. I know, God, I can see her. Then he stopped for a moment. This is what he said. Lord, when we get to heaven, we will not be running to see each other. We both will be running to see the Lord who died for us. And on that way, we might come across and see each other and enjoy our friendship. What a beautiful way to put it. We don't go to heaven primarily to see our departed loved ones. We go there to see the Lord who died for us on the cross. Even in life and death, It is Jesus that we long to see. It is all about Jesus. It's all about his love for us. You know, as Psalmist says, that Lord, teach me to number my days right, that I may gain a heart of wisdom. Now here is a dear auntie who lived her life well. She loved her Lord. She was not afraid of death. She knew her timing. You know, there were sisters talking about the dreams that they had about her. She was able to count her days. She was able to plan well. In the book of Hebrews, it tells us that run the race with perseverance, the race that is marked out for us. നമ്മുടെ മുമ്പിൽ വെച്ചിട്ടുള്ള ഓർക്കും മലയാളത്തിൽ പറയുന്നു ഇംഗ്ലീഷിൽ race that is marked out for us. Everybody sitting here today, please understand, God has a race marked out for everyone here. That's the reason Paul prayed in Ephesians. God, my prayer for the Ephesian believers, that you would open the eyes of their inner heart. They would see the hope of your calling. They would see the hope of your calling. All of us sitting here today, we have come, most of us have come from India. 4 decades ago, 5 decades ago, maybe 2 decades ago. The Lord saved you, brought you to this land for a purpose. There's a picture God has formed for you. There's a race marked out for you. We will be wise if we can get a glimpse of that race. I'm not talking about the tombstone. You can pay any artist and get that verse inscribed into the tombstone saying, I have fought a good fight. And I believe when your children or your brother or sister or somebody orders a tombstone and they ask them to inscribe that verse into that stone, that you would ask a serious question to you. Did my mother or my brother, my sister, my dad, did he run the race? Make it easy for them. Make it easy for your children. Make it easy for your loved one. Let us run our race well. Race is not the chronological age that we live in. Just because you're 60 years of age, that does not mean you have almost finished 60% of your race. No, you haven't. Maybe you haven't started. I pray that as you celebrate this life and be part of this homegoing service, that each of us will ask a question to ourselves. Where am I in my race? Where am I in my race? Christianity is a relationship with Jesus. Have you made that relationship with Jesus? If you have, praise God for you. If you have not, I pray that as you witness this homegoing service, I pray that you would open your heart and establish that relationship with Jesus. If you have established a relationship with Jesus as a pastor, as an evangelist, I want to ask you this question. How far is your race? Are you running the race? Are you on the course? Run with perseverance, race that is marked out for us. This auntie lived in a world, maybe in the latter years of her life, she was bound to a wheelchair, physical conditions. I remember her son saying, this is not the mom that I want to remember. In this condition, he was talking about memories that he had over the years. But Revelation 21, Jesus tells all of us who are worried about our physical conditions, challenge of sin, deterioration. Jesus tells one thing, behold, I make everything new. Behold, I make everything new. Starting all over. But there is no more sin. No more tears. No more death. I am the Alpha. I am the Omega. Everything starts with me. Everything finishes with me. I am in charge. What a hope that is. We know we suffer in this injustice, suffer deterioration, sickness in this world. But the Lord is preparing a new heaven and a new earth and a new body for us. That's all that we have. One day we know that the trumpet will sound. Dead in Christ will rise up from their graves. We will see our loved ones with a glorified body to meet the Lord in the air. So as I close here, I want to just ask you a simple question. Are you ready to meet the Lord? If this is our last day, are you prepared? How far is your race? Look at the things above, not the things below. Don't be looking for life on this earth. If we are only concerned about life on this earth, we are the most pitiable people on the face of the earth. Think about eternity. I always love the prayer of George Ferber, the founder of Operation Mobilization. He always prayed, God, stamp eternity into my eyes. Stamp eternity into my eyes. See, this glass were eternity. There are times when we come together for church, we put on our glass of eternity for 2 hours. We take it off. But once eternity is stamped in your eyes, everything you see, you will look at it from an eternity's point of view. Every person stuck in traffic, you would see them as people going without Christ. When Jesus saw the multitude, he saw them sheep without a shepherd. It's all because he looked through the eyes of eternity. Look at every relationship from an eternity's point of view. Your life on this earth, look at it from an eternity's point of view. This world is not our home. Our home is somewhere beyond. Life on this earth is temporary, it's transient. The life to come is eternal. And I pray that the Lord will comfort the hearts of Mother Vijayan, his children, all his loved ones here, church members. May the peace of God and the God of peace be closer to you at this time. God bless all of you. Thank you so much.
There are so many people we need to thank. If I do not mention you by name, it's a simple oversight. Everyone has a place in our heart. We are so thankful for the love and compassion that has been showered upon us during this difficult time. First, let's thank the ICC Shalom Church in Sunrise and Pastors John Thomas and Casey John and all the members, believers in the church. The Believers Assembly in Davie, the Martha Mar Churches, South Florida, Pastors Jacob Matthew, Joseph K. Joseph, Joshua Joseph, and all the men of God who were with us last night and here today. Brother Isaac Burgess for hosting our family, John Mathai and family, Sosma Matthew and family, Paul George, Jesse George and family, Stacy Hadichan for her help and guidance, the Malayalam and English worship teams, thank you, the sound system, Tony Zachariah and his group, thank you, the Malabar catering service, Stephen George, thank you. Our friends and neighbors in Country Glen, thank you for your love and condolences. Daddy's and Shirley's friends and co-workers from work. The doctors and staff who took care of Mummy for years. Our family and friends from Chicago, Dallas, and New York. Our friends from Orlando, everyone who sent their condolences, everyone who sent food and the beautiful flowers, thank you. To the Cooper City Emergency Squad and the staff at the Memorial West ER, thank you for trying to save Mummy. And last, the staff here at Forest Lawn. Thank you, all of you, for your love, your prayer, your condolences. Please keep us all in your prayers. Please pray for Daddy. Even though he's not alone, you know, he will need a phone call, a visit every once in a while to let him know that even though he's spiritually with God, present with all our love and physically, we are thinking of them always. Thank you all.
Namaku Pratik. Parishudhanaya Devadinaya Pidavi. Amudha Snehathinaya Kaithanaya. Namakoda Amudha Vidharathinaya Namakoda Kaithanaya Pidavi. Kaithanaya Pidavi. പ്രിയകർത്താവിൻ്റെ ദാസിയെക്കുറിച്ച് അനേക കാര്യങ്ങൾ കേൾക്കുവാൻ നല്ല നല്ല സൽപ്രവൃത്തികളെ കുറിച്ച് ഓർക്കുവാൻ ഇടയാകുന്നതിന് ആശ്രമം ഇന്നലെ ഇന്നുമായി നിങ്ങളെ അനുഗ്രഹിച്ചതിന് ആശ്രമം അനുഗ്രഹിക്കപ്പെട്ട ഒരു യാത്രയെ കഴിഞ്ഞ രണ്ട് ദിവസം വിവിധ നിലയിൽ വിവിധ വിഷയങ്ങളിലൂടെ വിവിധ ശുശ്രൂഷയിലൂടെ ചെയ്യുവാൻ ഇടയാകുന്ന ആശ്രമം ഈ പലക്കാലം അനുഗ്രഹിക്കപ്പെട്ട കർത്താവിൻ്റെ വലിയ ശുശ്രൂഷിപ്പാൻ കർത്താവിന്റെ ദാസികൾക്ക് ബലപ്പെടുത്തിയിരുന്ന ആശ്രമം ദൂരത്ത് നിന്നും ജാഗ്രത നടന്ന നല്ല റിലേഷൻഷിപ്പുകളെ ഓർക്കുന്നു ബന്ധുമിത്രങ്ങളെ ഓർക്കുന്നു സഭാവിശ്വാസികളെ കുടുംബങ്ങളായി ഓർക്കുന്നു ദൈവദാസന്മാരെ ഓർക്കുന്നു ഈ ശിശുവിനെ സംബന്ധിപ്പാനൊക്കെ അവരെ അവർ നേടിയാക്കിയ ആശ്രമം കർത്താവ് ഞങ്ങളുടെ നാളുകൾ വീണ്ടും ഈ ലോകത്തിലായിരിക്കും അടുത്ത സമയം ഇവിടെ ആരുടെ ശുശ്രൂഷ നടത്തുന്ന ഞാൻ അറിയുന്നില്ല എന്നാൽ ഈ ദിവസങ്ങളിൽ കേട്ട വചനങ്ങൾ പ്രത്യാശ ഉണർത്തിക്കൊണ്ട് കർത്താവിന് വേണ്ടി ജീവിപ്പാൻ ഒരുങ്ങുവാൻ ഒരുക്കുവാൻ ഞാൻ കരിമാറ്റിയാകണമെന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു കാലമെല്ലാം കഴിഞ്ഞു കാണുന്നതെല്ലാം കഴിഞ്ഞു നിത്യത വരുമ്പോൾ ആ നിത്യതയെ കാണാൻ ആഗ്രഹത്തോടെ പ്രത്യാശ ജീവിപ്പാൻ പ്രിയ സഹോദരിയുടെ റിലേഷനോട് എല്ലാ കുടുംബങ്ങളെയും ഓർത്ത് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു ദൂരത്ത് ജാഗ്രത നടന്നുകൊണ്ട് എല്ലാ പ്രിയപ്പെട്ടവരോട് ബലപ്പെടുത്തുന്നു അവരുടെ മടക്കയാത്രയും കൂടി സെർബിയയിൽ നടക്കുന്ന ആയുസ് ശുചിയായിട്ടുള്ളതാണ് കർത്താവിദാസിനെ ഉപയോഗിക്കണമേ കൂടെ ശുശ്രൂഷിക്കുന്നവരെ വേണ്ടി ശക്തീകരിക്കുകയും സഹായിക്കുകയും പ്രത്യാശയോഗ്യങ്ങളുടെ ഭാഗം എല്ലാവർക്കും പ്രായ ധാരണ യേശുനാഥ വേഷിക്കുന്നു വേണ്ടി അടുത്തുള്ള മാറാം പിതാവായി ആശ്വസിച്ച് വഴി മനസ്സവാസ കൂട്ടായിരുന്നില്ല വിഷയങ്ങളോട് കൂടി ദുഃഖത്തിലായിരിക്കുന്ന വാശിന്റെ കുടുംബങ്ങളോടുകൂടി തുടർന്ന് നടക്കേണ്ട സമയത്തിലെ ശുശ്രൂഷകളോടുകൂടി ഇപ്പോഴും പിന്നിട്ടാണ് പലവിടെ ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നു
come. Yeah.
ത്രയാകുന്നിതാ പ്രിയജനമേ കരയല്ലേ കരയല്ലേ പോകുന്നു യാത്രയാകുന്നിതാ പ്രിയജനമേ കരയല്ലേ കരയല്ലേ പോകുന്നു ഞാൻ ഈ കണ്ണുനീരിൽ കാണുന്നു സ്നേഹത്തി കടലെന്നാലും പോകാതെ വയ്യ കണ്ണുനീരിൽ കാണുന്നു സ്നേഹത്തിൻ കടലെന്നാലും പോകാതെ വയ്യ യാത്രയാകുന്നിതാ പ്രിയജനമേ കരയല്ലേ കരയല്ലേ പോകുന്നു ഞാൻ പൈതങ്ങളെ പാതയോരത്താക്കി പിരിയുന്നു മോഹമായി കരുണാമയൻ കൂട്ടായി വരും സ്നേഹിച്ചു മുത്തങ്ങൾ തന്ന പൈതങ്ങളെ പാതയോരത്താക്കി പിരിയുന്നു മോഹമായി കരുണാമയൻ കൂട്ടായി വരും പരലോകവാടിയിൽ കാണാം വീണ്ടും യാത്രയാകുന്നിതാ പ്രിയജനമേ കരയല്ലേ കരയല്ലേ പോകുന്നു ഞാൻ ഈ കണ്ണുനീരിൽ കാണുന്നു സ്നേഹത്തിൻ കടലെന്നാലും പോകാതെ വയ്യ ഈ കണ്ണുനീരിൽ കാണുന്നു സ്നേഹത്തിൻ കടലെന്നാലും പോകാതെ വയ്യ യാത്രയാകുന്നിതാ പ്രിയജനമേ കരയല്ലേ കരയല്ലേ പോകുന്നു ഞാൻ പ്രവൃത്തികൾ കൊണ്ടോ വേദനിപ്പിച്ചെങ്കിൽ ക്ഷമ ചോദിക്കുന്നു കൂടാരം വേടിയും കുഞ്ഞാടു ഞാൻ വാക്കുകൾ കൊണ്ടോ പ്രവൃത്തികൾ കൊണ്ടോ വേദനിപ്പിച്ചെങ്കിൽ ക്ഷമ ചോദിക്കുന്നു കൂടാരം വേടിയും കുഞ്ഞാടു ഞാൻ ഈ ലോകവാസം പുൽക്കൊടി പോലെ യാത്രയാകുന്നിതാ പ്രിയ ஜனமே கரையில்லை கரையில்லை போகுன்னு ஞா ஈ கண்ணு நீரில் காணுன்னு ஸ்நேகத்தின் கடல் என்னாலும் போகாதே வையா ஈ கண்ணு நீரில் காணுன்னு ஸ்நேகத்தின் கடல் என்னாலும் போகாதே வையா யாத்ரையாகும் நிதா பிரியஜனமே கரையில்லை கரையில்லை போகுன்னு நான் கரையில்லை கரையில்லை போகுன்னு நான்
excellence them all. Favor is deceitful and beauty is vain. but a woman that fears the Lord shall be praised. Today, we have come at the last minute. Sometimes we may shed tears that is not tears of any discouragement, with the hope and love that Jesus will come back soon. And our sister will rise up in glory and with a celestial Amen. Body that God will give it to her. So let us come and we read in the Word of God at the time of the death of Stephen, the godly men buried him. Hathiyulla, Pushanmar, Stephanos, Nehadkanchi. So now we are as God's children with great hope that we are assembled here and bury our body and hoping for that resurrection day when Jesus Christ comes, that she will rise up. And Jesus himself said, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believes in me, though he were dead, yet shall live. And whosoever lives and believes in me shall never die. At this moment, there are some scripture selection. Some of our pastors will read here, starting from book of 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 20 to 28, 15, 35 to 49, 15, 50 to 58, and 1 Thessalonians 4, 13 to 18.
But now Christ is risen from the dead, and has become the first fruit of those who have fallen asleep. For since by man came death, by man also came the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all died, even so in Christ all shall be made alive. But each one in his own order, Christ the firstborn, afterward those who are Christ and his coming. Then comes the end, when he delivers the kingdom to God the Father, when he puts an end to all rule and all authority and power. For he must reign till he has put all enemies under his feet. The last enemy that will be destroyed is death. For he has put all things under his feet. But when we say all things are put under him, it is evident that he who put all things under him is expected. Now when all things are made subject to him, all that the Son himself will also be subject to him. Who put all things under him, that God may be all in all.
1 Corinthians 15, 35 to 49.
ഒരുവൻ മരിച്ചവർ എങ്ങനെ ഉയർത്തുന്നു എന്നും ഏതുവിധം ശരീരത്തോടെ വരുന്നുവെന്നും ചോദിക്കും. കൂടാ നീ വിതയ്ക്കുന്നത് ചത്തില്ല എങ്കിൽ ജീവിക്കുന്നില്ല. നീ വിതയ്ക്കുന്നതോ ഉണ്ടാകുവാനുള്ള ശരീരമല്ല, ഗോതമ്പിന്റെയോ മറ്റു വല്ലതിന്റെയോ ഒരു മണിയത്രേ വിതയ്ക്കുന്നത്. ദൈവമോ തന്റെ ഇഷ്ടം പോലെ അതിന് ഒരു ശരീരവും ഓരോ വിത്തിനെ അതിന്റെ ശരീരവും കൊടുക്കുന്നു.
I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as bride, beautifully dressed for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, look, God's dwelling place is now among the people, and he will dwell among with them. They will be his people, and God himself will be with them and be their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death, no more mourning, or crying, or pain, for the whole order of things has passed away.
Yeah.
gave us with that present hope we are standing here. കർത്താവുടെ ഗംഭീരനാഥത്തോടും പ്രധാന ദൂതന്റെ ശബ്ദത്തോടും ദൈവത്തിന്റെ കാഹളത്തോടും കൂടെ സ്വർഗത്തിൽ നിറങ്ങി വരും. ക്രിസ്തുവിൽ മരിച്ച വിശുദ്ധന്മാർ ഉയർത്തെഴുന്നേൽക്കും. ആ പുനരുദ്ധാനത്തിന്റെ പൊൻപുലരിയിൽ ഇന്ന് ഈ പകൽക്കാലം നമ്മൾ ഈ സംസ്കരിക്കുന്ന നമ്മൾ പ്രിയമാന്യ സഹോദരിയുടെ ശരീരവും തേജസ്സോടെ ഉയർത്തുവരും. Hallelujah. In the name of the Father and the Son and of the Holy Spirit, thus thou art and to dust shalt thou return. Jesus Christ, our Savior, at the last day, rise you from the dead. നീയോ അവസാനം വരുവോളം പോയിക്കൊള്ളുക. നീ വിശ്രമിച്ച് കാലാവസാനത്തിങ്കിൽ നിന്റെ ഓഹരി പ്രാപിപ്പാൻ എഴുന്നേറ്റു വരും. കർത്തൃകാഹളം യുഗാന്ത്യകാലത്തിൽ
വിശുദ്ധന്മാരുമായുള്ള ഈ വിശുദ്ധ സഭായോഗത്തെ സംബന്ധിച്ച് ദേശത്ത് പാർത്തോ നല്ല സാക്ഷ്യം വഹിപ്പാൻ നിന്റെ മകൾക്ക് ഇടയാക്കി ഓർത്ത് സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു. അവിടുത്തെ സമയമായപ്പോൾ കഷ്ടവും ദുഃഖവും നെടുവീർപ്പും ഒന്നുമില്ലാത്തതായ അങ്ങയുടെ സന്നിധിയിൽ അങ്ങയുടെ ദാസിയെ വിളിച്ചു വേർതിരിച്ചത് ഓർത്ത് നന്ദിയോട് സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു. മഹത്വകരമായൊരു പ്രത്യാശ ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് നൽകിയിരിക്കാൻ സ്തോത്രം. ഞങ്ങൾ മണ്ണിൽ നിർത്തതായ പ്രിയ സഹോദരിയെ ഈ മണ്ണിന് ഏൽപ്പിച്ചിരിക്കുന്നു. കർത്താവെ, അവിടുന്ന് നേരെ താമസിയാതെ കാകളം മുഴക്കുമ്പോൾ മരണമേ നിന്റെ ജയം എവിടെ എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞുകൊണ്ട് എഴുന്നേറ്റ് വരുന്നതായ ഒരു നല്ല ദിനമുണ്ടല്ലോ, അതോർത്ത് ഞങ്ങളങ്ങ് സ്തുതിക്കുന്നു. പ്രിയ സഹോദരി മാത്രമല്ല, ഈ ഗ്രേവ്യാർഡില് ലോകത്തിന്റെ വിവിധ ഭാഗങ്ങളില് ക്രിസ്തുവിൽ മരിച്ചിട്ടുള്ള അനേക വിശുദ്ധന്മാർ ഒന്നിച്ചെഴുന്നേൽക്കുന്ന ആ നല്ല നാളിനായി ഞങ്ങളങ്ങ് സ്തുതിക്കുന്നു. ദുഃഖത്തിലായിരിക്കുന്ന മാത്തുക്കൊട്ടുപറിനെയും ഷേളിയെയും ഷാദിയെയും കുടുംബത്തെയും അവിടുന്ന് ആശ്വസിപ്പിക്കുമാറാകണം. ഇനി അവർക്ക് മദറില്ല, എന്നാൽ മദറിനെ പോയി കാണാം, യേശുവിനോടുകൂടെ കാണാമെന്നുള്ള പ്രത്യാശ ചെയ്യുക. ആശ്വാസങ്ങൾ ഓരോ ദിവസം പ്രാപിച്ചോണ്ട് ചെയ്യുക. ഇടയാക്കുകയാണോ എന്ന് നിങ്ങൾ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. ചർച്ചക്കാരായി ബന്ധുമിത്രാദികളായി ലോകത്തിന്റെ വിവിധ ഭാഗത്തുനിന്ന് കടന്നു വന്ന എല്ലാവരെയും ആശ്വസിപ്പിക്കണമേ, ആശ്വസിക്കുമാറാകണമേ. ശിശുഷ ദാസനെ അധികാരപ്പെടുത്തി ഓർത്ത് സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു. ഞങ്ങൾ അങ്ങോട്ടും ഇങ്ങോട്ടുമായി പിരിഞ്ഞു പോകട്ടെ, പിരിയാത്ത ബന്ധത്തിൽ ഞങ്ങളെ കാത്തുകൊള്ളണമേ കർത്താവേ. എല്ലാം നമ്മളാൽ നിറയ്ക്കും. ഒരു പ്രാവശ്യം കൂടെ ദുഃഖത്തിലായിരിക്കുന്ന കുടുംബത്തെ അവിടുത്തെ തർക്കരങ്ങളെ കേൾപ്പിക്കുന്നു, സമാധാനിപ്പിക്കുന്നു.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. And the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all, ever and ever. Amen.
ക്രിസ്തുയേശു മുഖാന്തരം ജയ നൽകി ദൈവത്തിന്റെ സ്തോത്രം.
The roses aren't as pretty, the sun isn't quite as high, birds don't sing as sweet of a lullaby, the stars seem a little bit faded, the clouds just a little more gray, and it feels like things won't ever be the same. Heaven got another angel tonight, you left this world behind, heaven got a little better today, took you away from me, I'm missing you tonight. I'll see you again sometime. For now I'll close my eyes and dream of heaven tonight. Aren't as lovely, the sky isn't quite as blue, still there, sweetened by the memory of you. The rain is a little bit colder, the fire is never quite as warm, still it seems that heaven isn't all that far. Heaven got another angel, this world behind, heaven got a little better the day it took you away from me, I'm missing you tonight, I'll see you again sometime, spending a little more time now with the things that mean a little bit more. I'm noticing the wonders of this world. I love with a little more hope now. I live with a little more peace, 'cause I understand how precious life can be.